that the non-Jewish children would attack us and beat us.
Did your non-Jewish neighbors change at this point? They become less friendly with you?
Very much less. Some of them even came, one neighbor came into the house and she said to my mother, "Well, where you are going," that was just before they were taking us out of the house, they were taking us to the ghetto, "You won't need your glasses anymore, so give them to me, your set of drinking glasses. You won't need your china anymore." So she just took it, let it fall on the floor. She said, "If I don't need it, so you don't need it either." But most of the people trusted and gave to the neighbors that they should keep for them, like linen or rugs or whatever. And when they returned, they didn't want to return to them anything. Not many returned. But their word was, "So many of you are still alive. Maybe 3% of the population came back, young people." And when they asked for their property back, or my aunt had gone back. My aunt is only a few years older than I am, and we're good friends. And she also had to go through concentration camp because her mother, my grandmother, left for America in 1939. And she was told she has to wait till her mother will become a citizen, then she'll be able to take her. So she stayed with brothers, and she too went through concentration camp, but we were not together. She did go back after the war. And she asked the neighbors, "Give me back just one rug or one tablecloth for a memento." She was told, "If you talk too much, we'll make you a head shorter." And some were murdered just by asking back for their property. And I foresaw this, even though I was all of 17. I knew the exact words that they were using to the ones who returned.